Alright, let's get right into the ZO1 spoiler. First off, this thing is ridiculously heavy for a little, you know, fiberglass spoiler or whatever it is. Maybe it's more than that. I do have the tool in there. Maybe that's what's heavy. It just feels pretty dang heavy for just a spoiler. As you can see, I've never opened this yet. This has been here for days. And as you know, in the old... Oh, that's what the weight is. In the old days, I would have had to open this a long time ago. I can't resist. But nowadays, I can wait a while. This looks like the tool. This is ZO1 add-on sticker, brand, whatever, right there. Ugh. All right. Yes, sirree. Whew. Now this tool was, I think, an extra 20 or something. So, riv nut, insert tool. All right, not too exciting. Let's look at the other stuff here. Get rid of these super strong cardboards, which are meant to like stop stuff from bending. This might be the stuff with metal laid inside the layers here, which I've seen on servers and things. And things that you do not want to bend. No, doesn't look like there's actual metal or aluminum in here, but as you can tell, they are pretty heavy. So that's where all the weight comes from on this package. It isn't the spoiler. It's all the packaging, the tool, etc. All right, did I get it? Missed one. Missed two. All right, get that on the ground. Boom! Whew! All right. What have we here? What have we here? Okay. Some of this tape crap. Come on, baby. It's taped good. ZO1 does protect their stuff pretty good. It takes a while to get out, but hey, protection is always good. I'm making a mess of all this bubble wrap, but whatever. I just open it wherever I can open it. All right, let's take a look at the actual piece, guys. This camera angle probably isn't even going to show you the whole piece. Right there. Let's see, is this sealed, shrink wrapped? No, it might. Oh, I see. It's just taped. It's taped. It's no big deal. I was trying to figure out how it came out. All right. And this is the clear tape, as you can tell. So it looks like all scratched up. That's just the clear tape. That's all that is. Whew. Damn, nice, nice. This one has, carefully put it down, this one has polished edges, which are rounder, not straight cuts with sharp edges. These are rounded edges. Polished edge is an option on this mod. You want it to look nice and not just like some cutout piece of plastic. And then, finally, we have the stealth piece. This is also the stealth option. And you go, why the hell would someone put something crazy like this on the spoiler too? Well, it's mainly for the actual aerodynamics is what it's for. Without that, you're going to have some messed up aerodynamics with these humps. So you put it here. Now, this is also sealed with protective covers. It'll be cleaner once I take it out. And you can see this is also polished here. It's a very smooth, rounded edges everywhere. Very polished and nice. And it does looks like it has plastic on both sides. So it's going to look a lot clearer when we're done. It's just for protection. And I was saying, and why this is clear is so it doesn't get your visibility too much. If it was black, right? I mean, they might as well make a straight spoiler then. And you'd cut off a lot of that rear visibility. So it's clear, so you got a little bit of visibility through here, all right? All right, no doubt you've watched many, many of these install videos before. It's one of the most popular Scat Pack mods there is. So you know that my very first step is getting the center line which is by the camera. So I'm going to go ahead and take a ruler, and I'm going to make my mark, and then I'm going to do measurements. You know, not the other way around. I'm going to make my center with the camera eye as good as I can, as well as I can. And then I'm going to do measurements. I mean, it's not that hard to get it like insanely centered. It can't be that hard, you know. It's just a simple eye lens and you go right in the middle. And make a low mark and a high mark right there. And then I might even do what, I can't remember the guy's name. The rhino guy that went to a buddy's house to get this installed. This guy that's done 5 or 6 of them. He's pretty detailed. Let's put it that way. He's more detailed than me. And that is a crazy statement. So what he liked to do was put a piece of cardboard and press the cardboard fully to get the most perfect straight line in the world. And that's kind of cool. I see that. I can see how it's cool. All right. So I put this here. I bend the cardboard to every line. Just like that. Next, I think we're looking at 2 feet in my measurements on each side. 24 inches. And that is from, see, I got to break that hood line right there, break the tape. That is just under. Now from here, I'm tucking in to the edge of this trunk right here. And actually, I might even go on the top edge of the trunk, which would be more accurate for the measurements that we've seen. Yeah, so I didn't go down here. That's not very accurate. It's a shorter distance. I want to go up here on this little cliff. And I can see right here when I do that, even though it's a little bit curved, you can still see. It's pretty much right at 24. It might be a mil further than 24, that line. But I mean, this line is so centered in the camera, I couldn't really complain either way. And let me just check the other side here. Punch that through. That's right at 24. And the other one was a little bit further. So I may go a dash that way. Just a dash and measure again. So we're kind of, all I have to do, it's so close, is make the line a little thicker. Can you even see that? I hope you can see that. Let me check the light. Yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad. Make the line thicker, and that's really is, it's that close. It's like 1 mil. All right, that thick line now, which I'll go in the center of, is 24 on each side. You probably can't see it, but literally the arrow on the 24 is right on the line, and we flip it over carefully. And although you have a mil or two difference, it's exactly on the line. Now, I don't want to hold it and drop this and chip my car, but trust me, that's in the center. That's the center for me. So I'm going to go grab a couple of nickels. I'll be right back. All right. Nickels, you say? Yep, I'm following that other guy's advice and putting a couple nickels under it as I place it. What the nickels will do is make sure you got the gap and you're not rubbing on the paint, which is what they taught me. So I'm gonna go get the circle straight over that line, right there. I'm also looking at the camera to double check the circle, not necessarily trusting the line. Camera is very, very perfect. Very, very perfect. Very carefully. pull this off. Probably drop nickels on my car. All right. That's it. We're almost at the scary part. Pull out these nickels and I'm ready for my first drill, guys. Let me make sure I have the hardware here before I do this. All right, I have all my hardware. Let's continue. All right, guys. Going slower with the drill. Oh no! Gotcha. I've watched this install so many times. I know that you get the little white trails of plastic in. Don't get crazy, don't poke it through. There is now a hole drilled in my spoiler. 3/8 is the rivet size. Wouldn't you know it's my dullest bit? That could present a problem. All right, I made use of a little Christmas tree bit. I probably got shavings all over me. Wow, it always looks like a rougher cut before you take the tape off. And then look how clean that is. Now I expect the nutsert will not fit per everybody else's experience, and you're gonna have to enlarge it just a tiny bit. Yep, enlarge it just a little bit. All right. Get this in here. Try again. Let me see what's going on here. All right. It took me a little bit to get the hang of the tool. But now that I got it figured out, see, the holes are very big here. You have adjustment. I'm going to just put in a set screw there carefully to hold it. Now you can go back to your nickels here and kind of set it where you want it. Right there. And you have a washer here, which is going to cover the big hole, of course. So I'm just going to put that in there. And I'm then going to go ahead and mark the next two holes on each side. Pencil, my pencil. And yes, this is pretty nerve-wracking, like everybody says. Now, let me get another nickel. Got to be consistent. Here's some nickels. Nickel for your thoughts, nickel for your thoughts. Stupid. Okay. I'm going to put a nickel in here to maintain. I'm going to first tighten that up a little bit. Now I'm going to maintain the same gap here. I want nickel again. Consistency, right? So I'm going to put the nickel there. All around it. Make sure I got a proper circle that I can find the center of. Okay. That side is done. And now I have another nickel, I believe. Over here. Put a nickel in there to lift it just that much, just like the other one. Hopefully you can see all that. Now you still got the nickel, and you're going to use the nickel almost all the way across to avoid all the paint touching stuff. So this is right there. All right, I'm ready for holes 2 and 3 drilling. I'll be back in a bit. All right, I'm going to give you a last human tip on this. What size drill is this? I'm not using a 3/16, a 3/8, sorry. I am using what's probably the next closest size bigger. Remember, you got to hone out the 3/8. This is perfect. I know you won't believe me unless you see it. 20, I just saw it. 25 64ths. I'm gonna go straight to that. You'll see. Man, I got some crappy drill bits. I'm using a Christmas tree bit to get to that point. Now to that 25th, 64th, or whatever we said. Straight through. Don't twist it. I have a... Hold on. Perfectly snug when it's in there. I'm going to take off the tape and then mount this nut. All right, we're ready for the next hold. So I'm going to do some placeholders here on all three. Snugging them up lightly. And then you're getting the idea. I'm going to go ahead and use the nickel trick across it all, and then do these edges with the nickel trick too. So you get the idea by now. All right, I got a nickel right next to the hole, and I'll seat it on the nickel. I mean, I do got a nice gap, and it goes up a little here. It goes up a little here, so you're gonna be very careful with your last couple holes. But right here, resting on the nickel, absolutely perfect. Okay. And I'll do the same thing over here. Ow. Put in an extra nickel there. Bring it down to the nickel because this is the high point. All right, next two holes. Be right back. Just checking in, guys. I got the second to last holes done. Everything is good. No screwed up nut certs. What I'm learning... What I kind of learned on the gun here, I was trying to figure out how to work it, and I couldn't even press it to get it started. And that's, let me show you. And that's because I had it too far on here. So this is the crush point. You don't have the leverage. I moved it out to the tip, flush, right? Now I got small, super strong leverage right there to bust it open. Then if it's not quite right, you can just turn it in a click when you're done and give it one more squeeze. Now, I just started noticing, maybe my first couple didn't do it quite exactly right, but they're fine, is a click. Once I get down to a certain tightness, I hear a little pop or a click. I think that's good. That's what you're supposed to hear. All of mine are tight, but that would be nice if it's a very clear click and you know when to stop. So that's something I'm also interested in here. Alright guys, I have a call out to them right now just to determine which way the main spoiler goes. I'll show you in a sec. I wanted to show you the unpeeling of this and show you just how cherry this really looks. You know, it may have been deceiving with all the wraps on it, but look how completely, really, really high quality this piece is. Super high quality. Yeah, I don't want to drop it. This last bit is pretty sticky. Come on. All right, so I will make your final clip here. Once it's done, all I'm waiting for now is to bolt it right up. That is a nice looking stealth piece right there. And just to show you what kind of got me a little bit, I'm not sure which way to put it. I'll tell you my thought process and where I think I should. So you see you have a gloss side, and you have a textured side. I am 95% sure the textured side is here, facing out, facing back. And the gloss, that would get so many fingerprints and scratches. There's no way that that gloss can be meant to face outward so it's visible. So I'm gonna wait and just confirm. I'm probably gonna just do the texture because that's the theme that this car is gonna use anyway. But I was just curious because I didn't find in the directions where it said which way should you put it. And only the clear had the protection, of course. Texture doesn't usually need protection film on it. Well, that's it, guys. I got it bolted up. Now I checked a couple other people's videos, and it does have the clear in as I was talking about, and the textured out, which makes more sense. So this thing is installed. Not for everybody, maybe a little bit big. I think it's pretty sweet. Really makes the car, again, more unique. Look at the rear here. I'll get you a better picture. I'll bring this thing out in the light a little bit, since it's hard to walk around in this tiny little work area. I'll be right back for the final look, all right? Let me just snug these up real careful. All right, now the car is a bit dirty, so just forgive that. And just kind of get a picture of the look. I will be washing it soon, but I mean, it's been raining every day. Even bits of little stuff that I haven't wiped off all the dust yet. Quite a unique look, quite a aggressive look, isn't it? Quite aggressive. I like it even more from inside the car, by the way. It reminds me of NASCAR, as dumb as it sounds, having that middle part there. And I'm surprised how really none of my rear view mirror space is blocked by the spoiler because of the clear. I can see the clear in the rear view mirror, but no black whatsoever. So it's a really nice, they must have measured and done all that stuff, and it's exactly out of your rear view mirror direction, which is what you want. Might as well show you my new hood vinyl I did today while I have it out here in the sun. This was a Blacktop Graphics. Now I'm not sure if I'm going to peel off the edges like I had it before. Probably leave it for now. I had one flaw, which, let me see if I can get it focused. Somewhere on the edge over there a little bit, but honestly, this is the best quality install I've done so far. I'm not about to just wipe this off, to rip it off. It's killer. It was almost $70. I think it's really awesome. So that's kind of two major mods for me for the week. Took a day off, went to the doctor, shoulder stuff, got to get an MRI, probably surgery, that kind of stuff. So I was just taking advantage to really just have a day to just regroup, do what I enjoy doing, and have some fun. So that's it, guys. ZL1 Wickerbill spoiler. I really need to clean the back of that for sure. I can see marks all over it. All right, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.